They say it takes 10,000 hours to master a skill, but the piano professor says it should take a lot less. It's all about how you practice, not how long. That's what we focus on. Now, let's look at today's video.
The question, did Soviet-era pianists use American-made Steinway pianos during the height of the Soviet Union? Steinways were sometimes seen, probably mostly out of Hamburg, along with Bechstein and Blüthner brands. Among Soviet-built pianos of good quality, the Estonia is a good example. Estonia was established in Tallinn in 1950 by order of Stalin, led by Ernest Hiis, and remained state-owned until around 1990. Their pianos were used by Shostakovich, Richter, and many others. The state sometimes provided the major conservatories with assortments of foreign-made pianos, though Soviet models were obviously more common nationwide. Learning the piano without spending decades on it is about working smart, not hard. You can access the Piano Professor Pack in the link below. It focuses on abusing diminishing returns to get the best results possible.